He saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. Said he saw the best in me. I guess I'm the only one got this testimony. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time, one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me.
A few verses, and you don't have to stand, but I just want to lift up beginning at the B section of verse 7 and then going through 10. There was given me a thorn in my flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. Three times I pleaded with the Lord to take it away from me, but he said, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weakness, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Our text this morning comes from a familiar passage where the Apostle Paul is unveiling his vision and his thorn. Many have preached this story, which tells of Paul as he describes and gives account of how 14 years ago, early in his ministry, he is caught up and taken into paradise. Paul goes on and declares that he cannot tell whether or not he is having a physical or outer body experience, but only God himself really knows. And while caught up in this paradise, Paul hears inexpressible things, things that are not permitted for him to tell. The story proceeds that because of the great revelations given to him, the apostle is given a thorn in his flesh to keep him from becoming conceited or getting a big head. Now, while this story has captured many believers and caused them to rejoice as they come to understand the blessing of the thorn, I believe even within the text read this morning lies another word from God. You see, if you hold on and stay with me for just a few moments, we can all benefit from understanding the struggle that Paul is really going through. Now, if you look at this particular passage, the scripture never declares the nature of Paul's thorn. But what it does say is that this issue, this problem, this one thing tormented Paul to the point where he begged of God for release and deliverance. As a matter of fact, verse 8 says, three times Paul pleaded of the Lord to take it away from me. And if there's anybody in the house this morning who's dealing with an issue or a problem or a situation, a thorn, let me tell you, your release and your breakthrough is in the house. And it's in the house today. Now, if we keep with our theme, a God that delivers folks who have been dumped on, there is a word of deliverance. And if you don't mind, I want to tag on to that theme and use for a subject this morning, the power of going through.
All right.
Now, in order to understand where I'm going, we have to go back to the beginning. Because you see, I believe that Paul's struggle with this issue, this thorn, is not really just about him receiving it to keep him humble. But the issue lies in him not understanding the purpose of his pain. Look at this thing with me. Paul is writing his second letter to the Corinthian church. You see, Paul, who established the church of Corinth, wrote his first letter to deal with a division, immorality, and false teaching that was rising up within the congregation. Realizing that his words of correction and teaching were not as effective as he hoped for, Paul wrote a second letter to deal with the issues at hand. Asserting his apostolic authority, Paul writes this severe letter to the church, winning back the backslidden and dealing with the offenders of the gospel. He then goes on and begins to teach and encourage and explain how where the law heals, the spirit gives life. He tells them about the glory of the new covenant that they now have through Jesus Christ. Paul tells him of the treasure, what you talked about, Reverend Rita, the gospel that has been placed on the inside of them. He lets them know that they have been reconciled to God through Christ being crucified, not counting one sin against them. Paul teaches them not to be hooked up with unbelievers and encourages them that as you excel in everything else, your faith and your knowledge, don't forget to excel in your giving. Paul is preaching and teaching, y'all. And this brings me to my point today. After everything that has been said and done, this is where the story really begins of Paul going through. You see, up until this point, Paul has been steadfast in his ministry. He is consistent in proclaiming the good news of the gospel. Paul is on fire for the Lord. He's fueled by nothing else but winning the world for Christ. But as we move in closer, this is where I believe Paul begins to feel the pressure of going through. You see, as Paul continues by chapter 10 of this book, he finds himself having to defend his ministry. Paul is having to defend the authority given to him by God as a carrier of the gospel in the church. He finds himself answering criticisms and false allegations made against him and having to rebuke the unholy, demonic, and nasty motives of those who seek to undermine him and his ministry. Paul is going through right now. Paul, who has endured much, is having to deal with haters out to destroy him. Now, maybe you don't call that going through, but after a while of hearing and having folks dump on you and talk about you, I believe it will cause even the most mildest Christian to rise up in their flesh. You're asking me, how do I know this? Well, it's in the Word. You see, in chapter 11, it starts about verse 16, where Paul, who is known as being meek and mild in his ministry, begins to boast and fire back to the haters. He says, look, don't take me for a fool. But if you do, then go ahead and receive me as a fool. Because right now I'm talking to you, and I'm not talking to you in the Lord. In other words, if you want crazy, I'm going to give you crazy.
Reach back and
reflect on the issue of his thorn.
Yes.
God wasn't trying to add insult to injury for Paul by having him remember what he had endured with the thorn, but quite contrary, God was showing Paul the benefit and the power of going through and how it affected where he was today. You see, Paul needed to understand that the effectiveness and the power of his ministry now was fully manifested, all because he allowed God to do his work in him and teach him how to go through. And this morning, there's just three things you need to know if you are to receive your deliverance and understand the power of going through.
All right.
The first thing you need to understand is this pain is purposeful. In the B section of verse 7 of our text, Paul declares that there was given me a thorn in my flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. Now, whether we like it or not, understand that this pain was conceived by God and carried out by Satan. In other words, God had a plan and a purpose for this pain. God realizes that it is through the trials and tribulations that we go through that he is able to build true character in us. That's why in Romans 5 it declares we should rejoice in our sufferings, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, perseverance character, and character hope. That is why we ought to thank God that he sees something in us that is worth developing and producing. You see, haters and adversaries, you deal with are nothing more than demonic agents being used by God to build you up. In other words, they're the ones getting played. You see, God, the omnipotent one, has given them permission to attack you. Just look at Job. When the Lord said to Satan, "Have you considered my servant Job? There is no one on earth like him. He is blameless and upright, a man who fears God and shuns evil, and has maintained his integrity though you incited me against him to ruin him without any reason." In other words, you try to stir up some mess on him to get me to destroy him. But oh no, because through it all that my child endured, he held fast to his faith. We've got to be like Job as we go through pain and say, "Though they slay me, yet will I trust him." God's allowed pain is working to kill our fleshly nature, that the life of Jesus may be revealed and alive in us. That's why we can declare while we go through, we are hard pressed but not crushed, perplexed but not in despair, persecuted but not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed, always carrying around in our body the death of Jesus so that the life of Jesus may be revealed in our body. Oh yes, there's purpose in your pain. Tell your neighbor, there's purpose in your pain.
Thank you. Right now.
The second thing you need to understand in the power of going through is that it's his power. Verse 9 of our text says that my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses so that Christ's power may rest on me.
Yes.
God needs us to recognize that while it's his grace that covers us in our time of going through, it's his demonstrated power that completes and fulfills the task at hand to bring us through.
Right.
As a matter of fact, when you acknowledge your insufficiency and your inadequateness, God's power jumps into high gear to move you to a place and a position where his power is operating in full force and his glory can be revealed in you. That's why we can't get stuck where we are, but we gotta press our way through. You see, 1 Peter 4 says, "Do not be surprised at the painful trial you are suffering, as though something strange were happening to you, but rejoice that you are privileged to participate in the sufferings of Christ, so that you may be overjoyed when his glory is revealed. If you are insulted because of the name of Christ, you are blessed, for the spirit of glory and of God rests on you. My brokenness brings his power. My weakness causes the weight of his glory to rest on me." So you're not getting me right now, because in other words, while I'm going through, God's power and his glory pitches a tent over me and dwells upon me. In other words, everywhere that I go, so he is. Every move that I make, his power is upon me. Come around and sit down right here. God's power is over me. Every time, every valley that I go through, his power is over me. All because he wants to be right there with me. That's why you better be careful about what you do to me. Don't respect me. future. In other words, I'm covered. I'm like Allstate. I'm in good hands. You have to recognize it's His power that's working on the inside of me. Just slap somebody next to you and tell them it's just about His power. For when I am weak, then I am strong. What you must realize is that although we have received His power, our purpose is still for Christ alone. In other words, everything that I do and everything that I go through is to bring glory to God. It's for no glory of my own. That's why the word declares that if anyone suffers as a child of God, do not be ashamed, but praise and glorify God that you bear that name. Because the benefit comes in recognizing that when you give honor and glory where it is due, you will receive your deliverance and your breakthrough. How do I know? Because the Bible says in 1 Peter 5:10, for the God who called you to His eternal glory in Christ, after you have suffered a little while, will Himself restore you, complete you, and make you what you ought to be, establishing and grounding you securely. To Him be the power forever and ever. Paul understood that. That's why if you look at chapter 13 of 2 Corinthians, you'll see that Paul is back in the game for Jesus. As a matter of fact, Paul is exercising his faith and authority as he deals with his adversaries and haters. He says in verse 2, and I'm going to give you the Kyla version right here, I already gave you a warning the last time I was with you, and I'm here repeating myself again. And let me just tell you, when I come back, there won't be any holding back. You want proof that Christ is speaking through me? But the truth of the matter is that you need to examine your own self and see where you're at with God. In other words, Paul said, I'm done with the dumb stuff, and I'm done with entertaining your foolishness. My purpose has been revealed, and I must be about my Father's business. I'm done, y'all. And I'm going to my feet because I understand the power of going through. That my pain, as painful as it may be, was designed to connect me to God's power. Was establishing me that I might walk fully in my purpose and my destiny. That's why I can declare boldly that my present sufferings are not worthy to compare with the glory that's being revealed in me. Oh, I had to go through for a while, y'all. But now that I understand and know what I know, I'm on my way out. Had no devil in hell keep me bound. Oh, I was thinking I was going to break under the pressure. But now I've become better. I'm stronger.
Guess I'm the only one got this testimony. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time? I said he saw the best in me.